an epic family adventure. And Zach, I want to start by asking you two questions. First of all, why was now the time to reimagine a show like Lost in Space? And how did this all come together in the first place?
I think we have to thank enough to four people in the audience who we really have to thank. Kevin Burns and John Jashney, who have been the keeper of the flame of the original Lost in Space and carry it forward with so much passion, and Matt Sazen and Mark Parkless, who wrote this awesome pilot, are sitting there as well. Big round of them. So they created this amazing thing. As far as now, I think why now is Netflix. It's very hard to make this show for a regular television situation, but being able to work on the scale that Netflix allows us to work, I think we all agree that we didn't want to do this show if we couldn't do it. Achieved, it was
going to
not be up to par. And so, you know, pretty much Netflix is
by
now.
Great. Yeah. Big round of applause for Netflix. It's so exciting for fans of exciting and new content. Okay, so Toby, hello.
Hello.
I wanted to start by asking, so John and all of the Robinson family, they seem to be characters who have a lot going on beneath. Can you talk a little bit about your favorite part about playing John, and maybe something you learned while you were playing him that surprised you about the character?
I think what I like most about John is that I think it's a real family. I think it's a real modern family that we're portraying here, and that he has faults. You know, he's fallible. He's not some ideal parent. Just exactly. And I think one of the things that I connected with him was, I mean, being a parent myself. And, you know, being far from the ideal parent of just wanting to be better and trying to be better as a father.
Yeah.
You are an awesome dad.
Well, and speaking of our family dynamics, so Molly, reimagining a series from the 1960s, you know, that explores those family dynamics. I would imagine that there might have been some updates to our mother figure. Can you talk a little bit about maybe flipping some of the traditional, traditional elements of maybe a female role in the 1960s, and was that important to you to get to sort of explore what Maureen is capable of doing?
Yeah, I mean, I love the original, and I certainly love the original Maureen, but we obviously live in a completely different time in terms of gender dynamics. And one of the things that I really love about the show is that, you know, all the girls and women in the show are really strong, and there's never a sense that they can do whatever any of the men and the boys could do. And yay! So it doesn't feel like it's like a rah-rah girl power thing, it's just the reality. And, you know, because this show takes place 30 years in the future, we, I think, have imagined the reality in some ways that we would like to see, you know, that we, hopefully, by then, will be in a place where we've dealt with all that. And in terms of all of it, in terms of class and race and gender, but it's incredible to play a woman who, as smart as she is, has also all these flaws and needs to learn how to connect with her kids in a new way. Yeah.
Maxwell, hi.
Hi.
So I wanted to ask you now, even though the original Lost in Space was a little before my time and a lot before your time, I feel like the line, "Teacher Will Robinson," is like such an iconic piece of pop culture. So first I wanted to ask you, had you ever heard that quote or that line before this came up? And secondly, was there any pressure sort of stepping into this iconic pop culture role?
Yes, I had heard the line, "Teacher Will Robinson," before from Family Guy. And I have big shoes to fill, and I mean, we all do. And I think that we all have big shoes to fill, and we have, I think we're taking our own spin on it while also keeping this same plane. And
you got to meet the actor who played. Can you talk a little bit about that?
I got to meet Naomi, and I am proud of her. We bonded over Pete Seeger and comic books. And I'm proud of her own friend.
That's great. That's great. All right, so Nina. I didn't want to accidentally say anything and, like, spoil anything. No spoilers here. But I picked up on a little bit, like, Penny is sort of, is she maybe struggling a little bit with her place in the family? You know, she's, can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I definitely think Penny, on two sides, on one, she's kind of the quick-witted, sarcastic middle child that always feels, you know, like she's never treated as the cute young one, but she's also never treated as the responsible one. She's stuck right in the middle. But she's also this romantic soul literature buff in the middle of the science family, and I think especially in the beginning of the season you see that she feels kind of out of place.
And will she sort of, can you preview anything about maybe the character journey that she might go on?
Yeah, I definitely think that throughout the season you see she becomes more comfortable and strong in herself, and she realizes how great she really is and how to be true to yourself.
Oh, that's great. All right, now Taylor, hi.
Taylor.
So Judy Robinson is, first of all, in this episode, girl, you were trapped in that ice, and I felt like, how can you talk a little bit about shooting that scene? Because it looked uncomfortable, to say the least.
Yeah, it definitely wasn't a comfortable situation.
There were no VFX there. You were actually, we put you in actual, like...
Yeah, in a little mold with the helmet that I had to go underneath and then step into. So it did really feel constricting in every way possible, which I think helped. But, yeah, I had some anxiety filming it, which... Suffer for your art?
Very method. It's very method.
I think we actually captured the actual panic attacks.
Yeah, you bought them. But so Taylor, when you're playing Judy, can you talk? She's such a very smart, headstrong, you know, character. And I was just curious if you had maybe a favorite part of playing her, because I would imagine maybe on days where you weren't feeling particularly strong, you know, she might have inspired you, or somebody like Judy is very inspirational. At least it was to me when I was watching.
That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, having somebody who's written the way that Judy is written, you have to rise up to the occasion in a lot of ways. She definitely made me stronger as a person, and she's much stronger than me, but... It's an honor for me to be represented in the way that she is, and so I have nothing but admiration and love, and I guess I look up to that character in a lot of ways, and I hope that I am a little bit of that.
You're a lot of that.
All right, and Ignacio, hello. How are you? Of you guys in this episode. So I wanted to start, Ignacio, can you tell us a little bit about your character? Because I'm under the impression that perhaps he has, he's not the same guy that we may have seen in the original series. So what can you tell us about him?
Bueno, la verdad que empezando por todo, quiero darles... Oops. Hello, there it is. What's up, Balcony? Nose, please, baby! What's
he like? You know, he's all about him right now. He's got one goal, to take care of himself.
No, the character of Massimo, not to.
Oh, sorry. No, I'm excited for you guys to see how it all unfolds. He's got very different values than the rest of the family, but you know, in time, hopefully, there's a little bit of a lesson to be learned. But right now, it's all about him. He's a blue-collar worker, and he just worries about himself. What are you going to do?
Both of our characters have you know, lived in the world and struggled. We've kind of conned our way through life, and I think what you'll see is the wits that we've had to get by on, you know.
Yeah, we need to survive. You
know? Yeah.
What do we got to do?
Well, so Parker, let's talk a little bit more about your Dr. Smith. Let's look back at it.
Dr. Smith so much. I was so touched to get a phone call from my manager saying they were gonna look like they were gonna offer me this role. I was, as a 5 and 6 year old girl, I would wake up before 6 a.m. watch the static on the TV, turn to color, and we're lost in space. And how many of you were like that as kids? Like really old fans. And for whatever reason, Star Trek didn't. I liked Lost in Space more, I think because of Bill Mooney. I think because he was an actor around my age. You know, he was like a kid, but it was in black and white. I mean, I was watching the show in the 70s, but Bill Mooney and his work in The Twilight Zone, and his work in Lost in Space. I mean, I was a kid, I was like, I like that guy. Like, he's really, really good. So I adored him, I adored the show. And when I heard they were gonna offer me the part of Dr. Smith, it was, since I loved it so much as a kid, it was really touching for me. You know, I was quite touched by it. Because I never, how could I even make that up, you know? So, yeah, I love that they made her into a woman, you know? Thank you, Ignacio. And I was about to reveal things, but I can't reveal anything. But you're going to see over 10 episodes the part I am, you know? This new Dr. Smith, so I loved it. We all had a great time, and it's so nice to share.
It's great. It's really exciting. So I'm going to, I have another question for Zach, but I think we might have a time for one or two audience questions. Oh, Dwight, are people already lined up? Yeah? Okay, awesome. Cool. So hang tight, and Zach. At the end of this episode, or throughout, we see maybe a couple of other spaceships sort of crash landing too. So, what do you have to say about that?
I don't want to spoil some stuff, but I think that one thing that is clear is that these are not the only people who end up on the planet. So, the show has a really great evolution to it. In other words, it's not, you know, it's one change from the original, was that this family encounters other people who will present their own challenges and alliances and things along the way, so that our world slowly expands. Because this is not, you know, just the Robinsons weren't the only ones on that ship, right? And so there's people, we have a big international cast. This is not like an American mission to this thing, it's a global mission. So you'll be seeing people from all over the world encountering the Robinsons and encountering what they encounter along the way.
Is there an experience that you guys had while filming the show that you would like to share?
I have an experience. First of all, hi Dario, how are you? Second of all, my experience was the day before my birthday, May 2nd, we were filming on top of a glacier, and I just remember seeing the amazing, beautiful view, and I just had a realization how lucky I am to be part of such an amazing show.
Any other favorite experiences amongst the cast that stand out? I see giggling. That usually means there is.
Molly, you were there.
When I think about the experience of the show, I think of Molly Parker and how she ran the Jupiter and how much she knew on set, how well she could speak that dialogue and do the switches and all the science talk. And, you know, when we all went on set, it was like that child again started to play. You know, I was like, ooh, how do you drive this thing? Pulling the walk. You know, I'm a grown-up, and so the experience of it was it was fun.
Zach, yeah, share my experience.
I don't know that I've seen
the hair and makeup trailer. I don't know that I've signed the proper paperwork to discuss that.
What you need to understand before Ignacio tells his story is that he talks nonstop all the time.
Nonstop.
And even if he's in the hair and makeup chair and they're, you know, trying to do his makeup and his hair, we had a hairdresser who used to hit him on the back of the head to get him to just stop moving. So,
you were there, and I'm honored that you were there to experience this.
I'm like sitting beside him, he's in this chair here.
I talk a lot and I move a lot. If I don't talk, I get aneurysms because I have a lot to say. And I'm horrible for makeup and hair people because they want to do their job and they're, you know, shaving and cutting you, and I'm like, So, we're joking around, and she's shaking me, and she puts the thing down. I look over at Molly to say something stupid. She's focused. And it was a timing thing. I turn around, our hairstylist goes up, and the machine goes, and takes out an entire chunk of my hair.
But like this much. Like it just, it is
like this big.
They had to make a wig for it.
And it was early on, yeah.
There's a little trivia for all 10 episodes.
I love it. But which one was Ignacio?
But which one? Yeah. Spotted.
Where was it?
It was right in the front.
A wig. There's a little wig space.
So, that's a pretty. You're welcome.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Everybody, you're welcome. If I don't see that on Wikipedia and IMDb by the time this panel is over, then we as nerds have failed. Okay, yes, we have another question.
Hi, me and my son were just watching it. He's 4 years old, and Toby and Max, you guys, the dynamic you guys have with each other was amazing. Max, I was just wondering, where did you get your emotion when you were like, where did you go to find that, like, when you were so upset, and you're crying, where do you go to?
Well, first of all, when I'm acting with Toby and all this amazing cast and crew, they make it really easy on me because they are such great actors, and the writers did such a great job. And I try to think of something sad, and I just let it happen.
Teach us.
The thing about this cast in general, and in particular these kids, and what makes them so unique, is that everyone is like really great people, which I think are a very rare thing. But like Max and his family are such amazing, like real, actual individuals who are not Hollywood people. They run a circus in Chicago that goes into challenged neighborhoods that don't have a circus. But look, like, these are amazing kids, and Mina Spencer Summers building houses in Ghana, and like, this is not a joke, these are like superhero human beings that this is like the second job in their life to be really good friends. And so I think a lot of the emotion comes from just being an actual person.
And just another thing to add, just to say it again, everyone makes it so easy to feel that emotion.
You're welcome.
It's so easy to cry when you're around
us. Well, it definitely feels like a real family up here, and unfortunately, we are out of time. I know, I'm sorry, guys.
After party, Toby's house.
There you go. Let's give a round of applause to everybody.
when we stepped back outside, there were two other girls. And I think it was Zach that walked out, and he says, you two girls can go home. So you messed up your lines, like, a little bit. And we've actually printed out a script for you. If you could just, like, look that over and do it again, that would be great. Thank you.
Oh my God, no!
I feel so, so bad! But...
Your first audition tape, though, you were under a table or something?
Yeah, I did it under a table.
You were under a table?
With a bed sheet, because it was the scene in the ice.
Yes.
So we got creative.
And Max just made us cry. Like, you know, we watched his tape, and, you know, you see all of these things, and it's really hard to find kid actors who feel like real people, and to, you know, to have that over crying, watching a, you know, an audition on the iPhone, which is terrible. I'm sorry that we watched it on an iPhone. That's a terrible, terrible thing. But we cried.
Luckily, they were crazy enough to offer me this without an audition. If I had auditioned, I would never
have been. But we dug up some really old stuff from England on you, some very good comedy.
I did a scene from Black Sails. as the captain. Really wanted to.
I have a story. I almost wasn't gonna be Will Robinson because I almost didn't find the script. I came home from school one day and I saw this script laying on our table, and I started reading it, and I asked my mom, "Hey, what is this?" And she's like, "Oh, we passed on this because it takes you away from home too long." And I was like, "There's a robot in this. He's my best friend. It's just amazing writing." So I auditioned for it, and one thing led to another, and all the rest is history.
I love it. I love it.